y'all, it's Alicia, and welcome back to Alicia's Crafty Hop Lop. I had to check, but it's Wednesday, y'all. It's hump day. Happy hump day. To my returning folks, welcome back. And to my new folks, all of my new subscribers, oh, I hope you feel super welcome here. What a great week it's been, and that's thanks to so many of you who have written in or posted or just texted me questions. And because of you, we really expanded the kind of videos we were doing. And we also became alerted to the notion that more new crafting videos were needed, not just on this channel, but on YouTube. You know, I think I always assumed, and I don't know why I made this assumption, that there were probably plenty of those out there. And yet when I first started, I know Kathy and I were saying the other day, we didn't have any videos like that. So why I just assumed that after I came on, someone would do them, because to me they were so obvious, I don't know. But then all of you started asking questions, and I went looking for tutorials to offer you, and they didn't exist. So you notice this week, if someone asks a question that I think will be good for the general knowledge, like, how did you get on a design team? That was asked by two people, actually, via email. And I thought, okay, I'll respond to it in general, because I think it's information people want to know and aren't sure if they should ask. On here, you can ask anything. If I don't know the answer, and quite frankly, like I'm still fairly new to this. I may teach art at college, and I may have been making things since I was a kid, but paper crafting, I am very new to. Like, it's under 2 years. So there are a lot of things I don't know. I'm gonna tell y'all a funny thing. So I got an angel gift from one of the angels, and they sent me a really cool gift. And it was a pair of the Tim Holtz scissors. Now, Tim Holtz makes many kinds of scissors. So, you know, you really have to look at the packaging to see which ones you got. And I didn't. I was just so excited. I wanted to try them out. But I couldn't figure them out. And it's because the angel sent me the set that's kind of fancy. It's like on one side is the clean blade for paper cutting. And if you turn it over, it's the serrated that can be used for like all different kinds of cutting. Talk about a fancy pair of scissors, y'all. Seriously. So I didn't know how to work them. And I was like, so Misty C had made a comment to me about, I should share with you that Tim Holtz scissors come in different types. There's serrated blade, there's clean blade, or like the angel sent me, the fancy pair that is one in one. So when she wrote to me and suggested that, I was like, and she's like, turn the scissor over. And sure enough, I figured it out. So you see, even after 2 years, I don't know hardly anything. I just share with you what I do know, because I think it'll help you on your journey. And so if you ask me a question and I don't know it, I'll always be honest about that. I'm the same way in my classroom. I think the better teachers know that they don't know everything. We may know where to look for things or get the answers, but we don't know everything. How can we? Nobody knows everything. Plus, those of us who love making are lifelong learners. We can learn as much from a new crafter as we can an established one. An example would be Miss Cynthia Aguilar. Like, I learned a lot from looking at her ATC. And it was a certain kind of clean crafting that really appeals to me that sometimes I can do if I sit on my hands. So you see, we learn from each other. But if I don't know an answer to your question, I will be honest, but I'm very blessed to be friends with so many lifelong crafters. And I mean people like Jelly Bean and Donna. And oh my goodness, Misty C is an encyclopedia of knowledge on so many mediums. Miss Judy. Pat started off quilting. Like, she's been a crafter also for like 30 years. We have so many people. Monty the Polka Dot Pinecone, y'all. She has been scrapbooking and teaching scrapbooking and paper crafts for like 25 years. So we have resources here that if I don't know an answer, I surely can find it out. You know, and these are people who are constantly reinventing the wheel because they're so comfortable with what we all would call the basics. They've mastered the basics. I mean, for goodness sake, Monty's have found ways now to lay down seed bead with double-sided tape because she's been playing around with materiality so much. She knows what may or may not work, and like me, will prototype and test. So we can find you the answers. Believe me, we can. So thank you for enriching the channel by bravely, and I've been encouraging everybody who's new, speak up. There are no silly questions here. So, and you have been, and you've made it a better channel because you have. As you all heard today, Heather's program, the Adopt a Newbie, was so successful. There's now a wait list for the next round. I warned y'all, I knew it, because nothing like this existed. So I knew that by the, like within 24 hours, all the slots would be taken. But the good news is that Heather and Pat are planning on relaunching a second phase of this. So if you missed out on this round, there will be a chance for you to participate in the next one. And it clearly, this is a very needed program. I'm in the midst of getting a lineup of our newbie video. Remember I told you I wanted to ask some people that are experts in different areas if they would be willing to do an expert newbie video as part of a series for you, and they've agreed. So some just want to think about what they want to do. They're still figuring out, you know, someone like a Susan Tootsie Tucker could teach you like 15 things. So she has to figure out what she wants to teach you versus someone like Heather's already told me what she will do. I've heard from Jelly Bean. I need to reach out to a couple of the others. And Tammy's Stampin' Therapy. I don't know if you all know this, but she's a Stampin' Up! Rep, and she's been a Stampin' Up! Rep and involved in stamping and inking for 20 to 25 years. So she's new to YouTube, but oh, she is not new to crafting. Remember I told you I looked at her crafts and I said that. I knew it. You can't help but miss it, y'all. When you see an expert crafter's work, you just know, because it's flawless. So I knew Tammy was just new to YouTube, not new to crafting. So she's going to do a stamping and inking lesson. And I think that's going to be really useful, because so many people have said, oh, I'm just a bad stamper. There are no bad stampers. Mm-mm. There are bad stamps. There's not knowing about inking. And you know what I just learned, y'all, just watching a video the other day? I don't leave the acrylic, when I'm using an acrylic block versus a stamp platform, I don't leave the stamp on long enough. Because actually some stamps need longer for the ink to leave the material because they're designed that way. So you see, there's all these tricks I didn't know. And so I'm really glad that Tammy's agreed to be part of this, because I think even those of us who can get a nice, clean, crisp stamp, which I can now, I think there are things I'm still not doing right. So I cannot wait for Tammy's video. I think that experts and novices alike are going to love this series, because we're all going to learn a few tricks. We're all going to learn a few tricks, and it's not going to be amazing. So you're enriching our channel by raising your questions. You're enriching our channel by telling us what you need to know. And it turns out, even people like me and my friends who've been on here for a couple of years are saying, wow, I learned a lot from this series. So you see what you're doing? By asking for yourself, you're gifting everybody else. So thank you for that. I really thank you. Well, tomorrow is Belinda's big day. And I know we've been saying every day, Belinda, we're thinking of you. And today is no different. Our thoughts are with you. They really are. And we hope that knowing that we've been checking in every day helps you through this and eases those, you know, nerves. The day before I go in for a procedure, Belinda, I am busy like a whirlwind. That's just to keep my brain off. That's how I deal best with it. But hopefully you have found your own way of dealing with it. Today I am going to do all work kind of responsibilities. I am going to do some tidying. I'm going to do reorging. I'm going to disinfect my whole kitchen. I'm doing anything but crafting. I know, not a fun day at all, y'all, but it's a necessary one. Yesterday I was so tuckered out, y'all, and you could tell I couldn't do a thing. But you know, in here I can't leave the disinfecting of the doorknobs or the dishwasher or things like that. So I did those things, but I gotta tell you, I left a big old mess everywhere. I was so pooped. So today, what I'm going to do, because it's going to help my sanity and work off some of the nervous energy, is I'm just going to put my house in order. It's going to take me hours, but I'm happy to do it. I did get a scleritis attack, and that means that I'm stressed. So that also is a warning that I need a little bit more rest, because that's a flare-up, and it's a fairly serious one when it starts. It's a warning that something worse can happen. So I have to heed it when it happens. I know those warnings, and so do all of you living with autoimmune. So if I ignore that warning, it's a mistake. I've learned that the hard way. So I will not be ignoring it. And, you know, just because of the worry and wanting to be up with my husband when he's up, I'm just not sleeping ill. I'm just not. I'm getting less than 4 hours a night, which for autoimmune is really unhealthy. So I also, like, day has become night and night has become day, and that's not so great. So I'm also going to try to get in a nap today to even myself out. So that's what my day's looking like. No fun crafting on the horizon, but I'll feel much better when everything is put right. That's just who I am. Because then I can craft with like an open mind. Plus, I want to kind of set up this table. Now that my husband's not here, I can use it for crafting every day. So I want to reset it up so it's my craft table. Because lately, y'all, I've been crafting in an unhealthy way for my back. I'll be honest. I've been watching your videos while sitting here on the sofa, and I've done some not good things to this 50-year-old back. So it's time I make some changes. And since I don't feel like crafting in my office, then I have to clear this table off and set it up for crafting so that I have some back support. So yeah, a lot of adulting, but it's a beautiful day here in New York. I will take a walk just to try to help get a little bit of exercise in while I can. Wishing for all of you a happy and crafty day. I did watch your videos, and later on tonight I will do some commenting, but I'm hoping for you nothing but happiness and good health. And Belinda, know you're in our thoughts. And of course, we're still wishing for Misty C. We're still wishing for P, and we're definitely wishing for Scary Carrie. Now, I know many of you made wonderful cards for everybody. So if you're still in a card spirit making mood, oh, I know Scary Carrie would love to get some. I know she would. So let me know if that's something you're interested in, and I will make sure to get her mailing address out for you. And that way you can send her a get well card if you'd like to. All right, y'all, that's it for me. Happy hump day to you. Happy hump day, y'all. Bye for now.